So I'm just going to carry on where we left off last night. I'm just going to carry on with the poinsettia flowers for now. And a bit on the fur. I'm going to just try and give these a little bit more of a definition in here. I'm looking at my picture on the screen there. It's a bit far away, but we'll just see how we get on with this. Just put some extra colours in so it doesn't look flat. Very light touch, this. This is quite light here, just here, see. This isn't right on the very edge of the red, it's just a kind of inside it. Now this bit is quite on the edge. A bit thicker there. And it kind of goes round. It's not on a point. Lightness here. Yeah. And along here. this is Caran d'Ache, so it's extremely high in pigment. This is number 582. I think it's called Flesh Pink, not sure. It's a new pencil, I got it for doing a portrait, person portrait especially. Most of this is going to be covered up. It's a little bit light around here. Most of that's going to be covered up with fur, which we'll do now. Put the darker ones on first. We'll just try this. This here, see how that looks. So this is kind of going to go in amongst the dark green a bit. Not filling it all in. And can't copy it exactly. I'm just going with it a bit really. Want some of them white flecky bits to show through there. Because it'll save putting white streaks in. That's all you need to do, I think, really, just to get the furry effect. There's some nice green here, see? So, in case you haven't seen the last video, I'm actually placing this, copying this, but I've placed it up here. I'm still going to get a bit of stuff in here because I'm leaving them all out. Still going to look nice, nicer. Carry those around there like that. Just put these through. Because the white, they really won't show on there. It's a very light touch. Hardly touching the paper at all, really. Actually, it took me a long time to get this right, this touch thing. I used to want to really press hard. Of course, I got used to doing that with different types of paper, which, you know, to make it work, sometimes you have to press hard, but you don't with this paper. This is pastel matte. You don't need to press hard. looking forward to trying a new paper out called Canson Velvet for pastel. That's supposed to be very similar to this. So, looking forward to that. It's always nice to try out new papers. Okay, let's put a bit of this in here. Of course, this won't show very much here. We need the lighter colours, really. So, we'll go with the sort of sagey green next, I think, and see what that does. Sagey green and, well, white. We could put a light grey on, I suppose, but I want to try and cheer it up a bit. Got a nice creamy white and a nice white. I'm going to use the Faber-Castell white because it's quite fairly hard, so it'll be nice for doing lines. See, so you get another take on the colour here when you put more colours in. Room there for this stuff. And there's a bit of green in there, see? I could just put dots of that on after that. See how that goes. Now, somehow we've got to try and blend this hard line that I've put around the all there. Try and blend that in. So I'm going over it now. And I think it'll probably just disappear. Probably. Yeah, it's almost gone, isn't it? I'll make sure that we don't see that. Don't want to be seeing that. Yeah, what I'm going to do with this is make sure we don't get any bends in there like I just did there. It's not quite right, but it got away with that bit there. So leave it. But that's the key to this, is just doing straight lines. And we've got some little lines coming through here as well. Some white bits in there. Short on this bit here, kind of fan out. I'll use some of the white. I think that might well be enough, actually. White up here. Now, I'm going to have to be careful to keep these straight. As you can see there, some of these are pale blue, but of course the white going over the dark blue at the back is actually giving us that pale blue already. And that's it, all good. Some more white streaks coming up from there. Looks lovely and Christmassy, doesn't it? This angel cat. I'm pressing a little bit harder here because I want these whites to really stand out and look like they're really in front, especially over these light here. They really need to show up. I'll probably put a few more in there. See, they're all different lightnesses, they're not all the same. Some lights here. Yeah, so you have to press a little bit harder here to get these to show. Because these are going over the green, you see, you can see them. Okay, so let's put a bit more white in there. Right, so now I'll put some white in here, in with the sage green. Just make it sparkle up a bit. bit softer there, see? Just soft. Okay, now up here, some whites just fanning out. Just try not to go over the light green, the sage green, because I want that to show through. Okay, now we'll get some nice light marks going through here, because there are some, and now they'll show up. Fanning out here, see? Put some light arcs in here. Try and go over that edge as well. It's quite furry, doesn't it? Not bad. Not bad, quite. Let's get on with the coral colour now. Let's just put that to the